Sri Lanka, also known as the Pearl of the Indian Ocean, and no doubt for a good reason. The kind of time filled with unique experiences we had wasn't compared to any other country we had visited recently. On this episode, we will be taking you along with us to Colombo, a busy city with a structural genius all around. Due to the city's strategic positioning along the east and west sea trading routes, it has been known to traders for over 2,000 years. Before we head into it all, do us a favor and hit that subscribe button. It helps us keep creating awesome content for you guys every single week. Colombo was so popular that it was sought after by the Arabs to the Portuguese, then the Dutch, and finally the British fought after the Pearl till it gained its independence in 1948. With majority of the population being Sinhalese, following Buddhism as their religion, this country has many beautiful temples spread across the nation. We visited the Gangaramaya temple. With it being our first temple we had ever visited, it was a peaceful shock to say the least.
Okay, so today we are headed to Gangaramaya temple.
In Colombo.
And that's going to be our first stop, so we don't know where we're going to head to next. We're just going to figure it out and see what happens. Our taxi's here, so we're going to check it out.
So once you get out of the car, this is what you see. That's the entrance of the temple. Not the entrance, the entrance along the side. This is the first thing that you see.
Yeah. So we're going to start walking towards the temple now, the main entrance of it, and we'll see how that is. So once you take your ticket over here, 400 rupees, Sri Lankan rupees per person, and you gotta take off your shoes over there. So we both are barefoot right now, and we're gonna start heading that direction to see what's happening. Inside the temple, and the site is just magical right now. Like, check these out. Like, the room in here is just humongous. It's crazy. What do you think?
I love it. It was a shock coming into this room.
Right?
I was like, what?
Like, we weren't expecting it to be this amazing. It's really beautiful.
Everything is decorated.
I didn't even see this part. Look at this part right here. Like, every single part of this room is just amazing. So we came out to the courtyard. It's pretty hot out here.
Humid.
But we're staring at something really cool. And from what I can tell, it has a diamond like dead center of it.
Not a diamond, it's a metal. It goes like this. Maybe there's a diamond in the middle of it.
Possibly. So I'm gonna show it to you guys.
Check this out. Oh, it's not a diamond, it's like a third eye. Look at it. So gorgeous.
I believe they're doing some sort of construction happening behind us right now. But this is what we actually wanted to see. This is gorgeous. I don't know if we can go inside there. I guess we can. I'm supposed to be in here. I don't know if I am or not, but I don't see anybody here.
This is a real crocodile. It is like taxidermy.
Pretty unique. Really nice. Okay, I really don't think I'm supposed to be in here, so I'm gonna head out of here. Yeah, let's head out.
After which we were approached by a tuk-tuk driver who offered to take us around, showing us few other sites for a cheap price of only 500 rupees. We stopped down the road at another temple named the Gangaramaya Lake Temple for obvious reasons.
So we are at the Lake Temple in Colombo, and we found a really cool host over here. I don't know if he's gonna show us around, if he's aggressive.
He doesn't look aggressive.
But
he's
friendly. Look at this one. Please don't bite me.
After catching these epic drone shots, we were on our way to the famous Independence Square, which was built to commemorate the independence from British rule. At the entrance of this historic place stands a tall statue of who the people call Father of the Nation, Don Stephan Sinan, who brought Sri Lanka its independence and was the first Prime Minister of then called Ceylon.
So now our tuk-tuk driver pretty much brought us to a place called Independence Square, and it's very nice.
Peaceful, very.
Peaceful, yeah.
It's not that hot.
Check this out. I'm actually gonna try and do a drone shot over here around this whole area, so check that out.
While in Colombo, we heard of a very unique mosque called Jami Ul-Alfar, also widely known by tourists as the Red Mosque. This mosque built only took a year and was completed in 1909, although at the time it wasn't as large as it is today. In 1975, adjoining properties were purchased and the expansion became into what you see today. We decided to walk around and get some shopping done for a sari for Medina. Red Mosque being in Pettah, known as a busy market for anything your mind desires. I even haggled a little and ended up purchasing a sarong for myself for only 750 rupees, while Medina was struggling to choose herself a right sari. Don't get overexcited now, y'all don't get to see her wearing the lovely sari just yet. Hit that subscribe button and click on the bell icon so you can stay updated on the video when it comes out with her dress to impress. On the way back to our hotel, we walked through a busy fruit market and even purchased some delicious fruits for later. Staying at the Kingsbury Hotel, the walk ended up being around 15 minutes, which we didn't mind. While we're on the topic for hotels, let's talk which ones are good. We gotta say, even though Kingsbury Hotel was close by walking distance to all the places, we personally enjoyed our stay at the Marina Beach Hotel, minus their shitty room service. We would still suggest to definitely go with Marina, as it has a way nicer pool with privacy and a balcony with most rooms.
This is the place. It's very modern, very light, and very white. And you can see the beach from here. That's the beach? Is that the ocean?
Yes, baby, but that's the beach right there.
Okay, so that's the beach. And this is the washroom. The washroom is my favorite part, honestly.
I see you.
It's so awkward. Don't worry, you can have privacy. So if you wanna, you know.
There's not gonna be any privacy.
Oh.
I'm gonna disable that switch.
Achcha, okay.
Now our Colombo chapter coming to an end. Don't forget to check back in next week for our next episode of Sri Lankan series. We have so much fun stuff to show you guys and can't wait to hear your feedback. So hit that subscribe button and stay tuned. Thank you all for the continuous support we keep receiving from you guys. Till next time, Ayubowan.